A man has died after he was shot in the California neighborhood. Police were called to 17th Street near St. Catherine, near Wheatley Elementary around 7:30 last night. Officers found a man believed to be in his 30s who had been shot several times. So far, no arrests have been made. Now the family says they'll move to escape the violence. Police say this home on Saunders Court was sprayed with bullets Wednesday night. 9-year-old Vincent Starling was in his bedroom when he was hit in the leg. His mother rushed him and six other kids to the basement where she called 911. We're glad he's okay this morning. The 9-year-old is out of the hospital recovering. So far, police have not identified any suspects. Very exciting. That means live music, food, and plenty of fun at the waterfront all weekend long. Let's check in with our Carrie Gray. She's live for us at Waterfront Park this morning. And Carrie, what can we expect from this year's festival? All right, Carrie, thank you. And in addition to the ticket information, if you want to look, check out a full list of this weekend's headliners and lineups, download our free mobile app or head to WOKY.com. Your time now, 6:06. Let's check in with Matt. Good weather for this forecastle. Your time now coming up on 6:15 now. Late breaking overnight, R. Kelly is back behind bars this morning after being arrested on federal charges. The 52-year-old was arrested last night on 13 counts of child pornography, enticement of a minor, and obstruction of justice. The R&B singer already faces state sex-related charges. He pleaded not guilty to those charges and was released on bail. President Trump has backed down from his effort to add a citizenship question on the 2020 census, but he is moving ahead with a plan to deport non-citizens from the country. Immigration and Customs Enforcement are expected to start those raids on Sunday. A senior official says about 2,000 people are being targeted. The ICE operation will take place in some of the country's biggest cities, including Chicago, Los Angeles, and New York. Matt, thank you. The avocados you normally buy at the grocery store are going to cost you a little more. In the first week of July, the wholesale price of avocados from Mexico were 129% higher than this time last year. Yeah, this three-hour adventure allows you to see Jefferson Memorial Forest from 30 feet up. That's where we find our Alex Durham as she's preparing to zip line at Zipline Kingdom. Hey there, Alex.
No, it isn't.
That's not the 4 feet that she was on earlier, I'll tell you that. All right, Alex, thanks so much. Let's check in with Matt now. Beautiful sunrise there behind you. And Forecastle is here. We're taking you live to the waterfront where our Carrie Grace will tell us about the thousands of people that will be packing in today. And a good Friday morning to you. Thanks for joining us. I'm Stefan Dingle. And as Matt has been talking about, it's going to be great weather for Louisville's biggest outdoor music festival where tens of thousands of people are expected to be this weekend. Our Carrie Grace is live this morning from Waterfront Park with more on what festival goers can expect. Hey there, Carrie. The youth football team is honoring the life of a beloved coach gunned down earlier this week. Brian Owsley was a coach for the Flagey Rams youth football team. A vigil was held for him last night in the park. The 27-year-old was shot and killed Monday evening on Cane Run Road. Volunteers say Owsley, who was nicknamed Coach O, will forever be remembered by the people he impacted. Fire destroyed a JCPS playground in the Okolona area. WOKY Chopper HD flew over the scene Thursday at Blake Elementary on Bonaventure Boulevard. This is a video of the flames from a man who lives just across the street from the school. No one was hurt. The investigation has now been handed over to Louisville Metro Arson, and foul play is suspected. Your time now, 6:38 this Friday morning. Imagine finding out your entire debt was paid off by a group of strangers. What a blessing, right? $6 million will go towards medical bills in southern Indiana. Who is receiving the generous donation? We'll tell you next. But first, let's check in with Matt. Hey, welcome back. It was a big night out at Slugger Field for our WOKY team. Our own Alex Durham helped throw out the first pitch along with WOKY's Ashby, our canine companion. It was also a big night for the Bats as well as they celebrated 20 years at Louisville Slugger Field. So for the rest of the weekend, they are throwing back, suiting up in the River Bats jerseys. Do you remember that? The stadium also has throwback prices to the way things were in the year 2000. And Matt, we've been talking about this all morning. It's great weather. A lot of things going on. You got the baseball game. You got Forecastle. What more can you ask?
There's going to be a few people down around Waterfront Park and Slugger Field here over the next couple of days for sure.